This year, I don't think the legislature has the stomach for revenue increases. We just passed the most significant increase in just about every revenue source that we had some discretion over last year during the special session. I seriously doubt that there will be revenue increases this year. There may be some targeted fee increases under the guise of charging an appropriate amount for a particular service, but I think the budget deficit, $1 billion budget deficit this year, $2 billion projected next year, will be closed through cuts in services. I think that runs the gamut. I think it means public health. I think it means public education. I think it means things that we typically have tried to carefully avoid cutting. I think this year they get cut.
So we're still in a predicament here with this huge budget deficit. I agree, obviously, more tax increases shouldn't be on the table. And that's what they're saying right now so far. I don't necessarily believe it. I think when we get down there next week, you might see some tax increase ideas come through, maybe targeted on certain businesses, so watch out for that. They tried to tax services, if you recall. They tried to tax, landscapers. Oh, they got on the computers in the end. They taxed computers, and they repealed that with an additional tax on higher income earners. So you might see a service tax come back on, maybe not computers, but maybe haircuts, saunas, gym fees. Those were all in the first tax bill that they tried. So I still would watch out for things that may be called fees, but they're actually taxes, backdoor taxes.
We heard last week that, talking about the budget, that we're not in this by ourselves, that there's 41 out of the 50 states has a deficit this year to work on. So we in Maryland are one of those 41s, and of course, the governors just met in Washington last week looking for that key word, bailout. I don't think they came back with too much, but anyhow, they were in there lobbying for some money for the states. If you were looking for what are we going to do for this, some of the things I just jotted down that we have talked about in the summer study and so forth, postponing the COLA for any state employee. Cut government spending, as Rick said so nicely many times. We're going to have some layoffs. It's inevitable that we're going to have people going to lose their jobs. Hiring freeze. I just was confronted last week by one of the department heads saying, how am I going to get this work done if you're not going to allow me to have the people? Well, you're going to have to work some way in, because you're just not going to have any new people.
I don't know if it was this meeting last year or my fundraiser where somebody said, you sound very pessimistic. And right now you're hearing a lot of pessimism. I want to be the first to say I see a note of optimism here. And what I see as a note of optimism is finally the economies are going to force the legislature to make some tough decisions. We've talked about serious reevaluation of priorities. Serious evaluations of, excuse me, where we're putting our monies. This is going to force the hand. There are a lot of sacred cows that are going to have to walk up to the butcher block because we don't have the printing presses operating in the basement for money. New Jersey hit the wall last year. Maryland's hitting the wall this year. Those tax increases were supposed to be the panacea, and they're not. The money's just not there.